video, we will see a way how we can swap faces. If you want to follow along, you can find the download link for the images and the PDF text in the description. First, we go to File, click on Open, and search for our image folder. Click one time on the image folder, and then you can click on the plus sign. We have now added the folder to the list on the left, so we can find it easier the next time we need it. Now we can open the image folder, search for the image we want to use, and open it. Then we go to View, and click on Navigation Window. This can also be done by clicking on Windows in the menu bar, then on Dockable Dialogs, and on Navigation. We can grab the tab, and by click and drag, move it to the tabs of the lower window. Then we can enlarge it a bit by dragging out the side and the top like so. We will come back to the navigation dialog box in a minute. First we click on the Layers tab to bring up the Layers panel again. Then we right-click on the layer and hit Add Alpha Channel. This allows transparency in the layer. Click on the Duplicate button in the Layers panel to make a copy. Click on the arrow to lower the copy and make it invisible by clicking its eye. We can use this duplicate as a reference. Make the top layer active. In the next step, we are going to make a selection of the face. This can be done in several ways, of course, and in this video I will use the Path tool. If you are not familiar with the Path tool, there is a link in the top right corner to a short, simple and basic tutorial. You will know within a few minutes how to make a perfect selection with the Path tool. Go to the toolbox and make the Path tool active. Then we can zoom in by clicking the zoom icon at the bottom of the navigation window several times. In the preview pane, we can move the inversely colored rectangle area. Usually, selecting works best when we stay just a little bit inside the subject. In this case, however, we will remove the face, so it's better to select a little bit outside the face area. While making the path, we can always hit Ctrl-Z to undo several selection points, and with Ctrl-Y, we can redo them. Moving the image can also be done by holding the spacebar and then moving the mouse without clicking. Outside of the face, we have to improvise a bit because of the clothing. When the path is made and closed, we zoom out a bit and move the rectangle so the selected area is good visible. Then we click on the button Selection from Path. Now we go to Select and click on Feather. Feather the selection with 5 pixels and click OK. Hit the Delete key to remove the face area. When we make a random tool active, the path becomes invisible. In this case, we can choose to make the Unified Transform tool active because we will work with that tool later on. Now, finally, we press Ctrl-Shift-A to deselect. Click on the fourth icon from the left to fit the image in the window. We will now bring in the image of the girl. Go to File, Open as Layers, search for the image and open it. Click on the downwards pointing arrow to place it below the costume layer. Make the image opacity of the Unified Transform tool about 60. And under Constrain, we check the option Scale to maintain the aspect ratio when we scale the image. Then we click the image to bring up the framework with the handles. We can scale this layer up a bit by grabbing the handles at the top, bottom, left and or right side of the framework. By click and drag inside the framework we can move the image, and we can also rotate it a bit by click and drag outside the framework. All this needs to be done precisely, especially where the lips shine through the veil to make it look natural. In the navigation window, we can zoom in and or out and move the rectangle. When it looks okay, we hit the transform button. When it's not to our liking, we just click in the image again and make some more changes. Then click transform again. Now we fit the image in the window. In the next step, we adjust the girl image so it matches the characteristics of the costume image. Go to colors in the menu bar and click on brightness and contrast. We reduce the brightness to -15 and increase the contrast to +20. Click the preview off and on to see the difference. Then hit OK. Again to colors, and now to saturation. Reduce the saturation to 0.5. Click the preview off and on, and click OK. Back to colors, and this time we click on color balance. Make sure that you have the midtones checked. Then we make the magenta green slider -10. And the yellow-blue slider +10. And again, click the preview off and on, and when we like what we see, we can click OK. We're now going to add some shadow on the face. Click on the new layer button at the bottom of the layers panel. Name it shadow. Make sure that we have the transparency as the fill. And click OK. Make in the toolbox the paintbrush active. Change the opacity to 30. Choose brush hardness 0.25. And make the size 300. Zoom in. And carefully make some shadows like shown in the video. Remember to use Ctrl-Z to undo if you do not like what you see. When all this is to our liking, we right-click on the costume layer and in the menu that pops up, we hit Add Layer Mask. In the dialog box, we make sure that we have white full opacity checked. Then we can click Add. Now we reduce the brush to about 100 by pressing and holding the left bracket key. Then we can, by carefully painting over the area where the hair is, delete a bit of the veil. In that way, the lock of the hair becomes visible. When we hold the Shift key and then click on the eye of the portrait layer, we can see how far the hair goes. Click while holding the Shift key once more to make all the layers visible again. And here too, Ctrl-Z can help. When we are satisfied, we can fit the image in the window again to see the result. Click on the thumbnail of the layer to make the image instead of the mask active. There appears a white border to indicate that it is active. Make the color picker tool active and click a medium pink color. Now we make the shadow layer active, so the next layer comes above this one. Press the new layer icon again and name this layer Eyes. Hit OK. Zoom very far into the eyes, but keep them both visible. Now we make the ellipse select tool active. Click on the second button at the mode, which is Add to Current Selection. Make a selection of both eyes like shown in the video. We have to stay just inside the dark edge of the iris. Click inside the selection to apply it. Click and drag the pink of the foreground background colors into the image. We make the mode of this layer Overlay. This mode mixes the colors of both layers while preserving the texture. Then we click once more on the thumbnail of the costume layer. Hit Ctrl+Shift+A to deselect. Zoom out. Again to the color picker. And now we choose a medium red color from the glove. Make the eyes layer active. And hit the new layer icon for the last time. Rename it Lips. And click OK. Make the free select tool active. Zoom very far in. And make a selection of the lips, but stay just outside the veil. Here we must use the backspace key to undo. Click the last note over the first one and then double-click inside the selection to apply it. Now we click on the third mode button, which is Subtract from Current Selection. Then we select the inner area of the lips. Go to Select and feather the selection with 5 pixels. When this is done, we can drag the red from the foreground background colors into the image. Now only the lips get the color. And again, we make the mode Overlay. Press Ctrl+Shift+A to deselect and fit the image in the window. To remove the navigation window, we can go to this icon and in the flyout menu we click Close tab. Now we can make the window a bit smaller again, so we have our original settings back. And there is our final result. I hope you have fun with this video. Please take a moment to like and comment to support my channel, and maybe subscribe if you haven't done already. Thank you very much for watching.